So guys, to get started with this, let's first download the required OS, that is OSMC for Raspberry Pi 3. So to do that, just navigate into osmc.tv and just get into download. So over here on the download page, you can get a tool that you can use to download as well as flash the OSMC firmware to Raspberry Pi, and the tool is available for Windows, Mac as well as Linux. Otherwise, you can straight away download the disk images directly, which you can flash to the SD card. So either way, you can continue to install the OS to the SD card. So over here, I am just going to download the required disk image to my PC, and I'll be flashing the image to the SD card by using Win32 disk imager. So just click on the image file that corresponds to your Raspberry Pi version. So if you are using Pi 1, 0 or 0 with Wi-Fi, you can go ahead with these versions. As over here I am going to use Raspberry Pi 3, I am going to install the latest release, that is of 1st April 2017. Just click on release date and it will start downloading the compressed file, that is OSMC TZT something with GZ extension. So just wait for it till it gets completed. Now after the download completes, you will find a file OSMC, and that is again having extension .gz. Now by using any software that you are comfortable, just extract the required file. And over here I am using 7zip, so you can use any software that you are comfortable with. Again, as I have already extracted it, it is showing me, do you want to replace the existing file? So as I am already having a copy, I'll just click on no, and sorry, not this one. Yeah, this is the extraction file that is something with extension, that is img, or which is the raw disk image file. Now open up the required software to flash the image to the SD card, and as I said earlier, I am using Win32 disk imager. So just open it up, browse the required image file, choose the drive or the SD card drive where you want to flash the OS. As I am having only one option, that is F drive, where actually my SD card is currently mounted, I am choosing this one. But be careful while choosing the particular device, as if you wrongly choose something else, it will corrupt, or you might lose all of your data on that device. Now after choosing that, just click on write, and it will ask you for a confirmation. Click on yes, and just let's wait till it gets completed. Now after the write completes, just click on exit, remove your SD card, plug in into Raspberry Pi 3, and let's check what the display looks like. Now over here, choose your language that you are comfortable with. So I'll go with English, then confirm, make yes. Then it is asking for time zone, that is for me it is Kolkata, so let's try K. So get it to that. Yep. Then you can give a name to your device. Currently that is OSMC. So I'll just change it. I'll give it a name, click on done. Click on accept. Now if you want to enable SSH, you can click on it, or if you are not aware of what is SSH and all, just leave it as it is. So by enabling SSH gives you access to the terminal of your OSMC by using any standard software over the IP. Now you'll have some license agreements and all. Click on continue. Now over here you can set your network. So let's set up the network manually. Let's get into wireless. Enable it. Yeah, I did a mistake actually, that white means it is enabled. So in SSH what I did was I disabled it. So I'll just rectify it later on. But over here let's connect to the Wi-Fi network. That is for me, we are genius. Click on yes. And you can see it has taken IP address, as my network is currently on Wi-Fi, it is on DHCP. So it has taken IP address automatically. So just click on yes, apply. Then you can have tethering and all. Then you can enable MySQL DB for video and music. I'll just click on yes. No, I'll not use it. Now let's exit. I'll go with OSMC theme. Okay, for timing I'm not going to sign in for newsletter. Now let's exit. Yep. Now it's all set. Let's try to fetch some videos and all from my network. Now after setting up everything, we'll land on a screen like this. We'll have some options like videos, music, pictures and all those things, like my OSMC that lets you configure your OSMC. Just like we'll have like log, then updates, services, app store, network configurations, the usual PI configuration and all those things. So let's escape it. And we'll have favorites, then programs and the OSMC settings. So we are not going into anything else. So let's straight away add some videos to our library. To do that, get into videos, hit on files. Then actually I have added one. So check that later one. Let's click on add videos and just enter a name for your library. Let's say I want to give it a name, Lappy D Drive, that is movies. Then click on done. Click on browse. It's okay. Now click after that, click on browse. As my files are on network, then you choose your network location or whatever accordingly. Let's say for me it is Windows network, that is SMB. Click on the workgroup, the PC you want to access, username, then the password. Remember for this part, then return. Okay, now let's say I want to add movies from D drive. I'll return okay. Click on okay. Yep, right now we'll have some options like what are the type of, like it contains movies or music videos or TV shows or anything. So accordingly it will fetch data and customize the library according to your content. So depending upon these options, whatever you choose, it will customize the library as well as it will download info from the internet depending upon the file you are having. Okay, now hit on OK. Yes. Now let's get back and check if you are having movies. And over here you can see it is refreshing all of the things from the movie database. And over here you can see it has fetched info for different movie in my library or the path I provided. And so on, it can be done for music or TV shows, whatever you are having on your drive. So guys, after OSMC is set up and all the configurations are done, we can do one more thing, that is we can configure the OSMC to be accessed by any remote application so that we can control it by using any other app or mobile phone or using the web interface. And to make things easy over here, I'm going to use my Android phone. And I will be installing one app that will be used to control the OSMC. So if let's say I am interested to play music or any video, I will not be requiring any keyboard or mouse that is connected to the Raspberry Pi or the OSMC. So in this manner, you can remotely access the OSMC as long as your OSMC Media Center as well as your Android phone or whatever phone you are using is connected to the same network. To control the OSMC by using the Android app, we need to allow it, and to do that, just get into settings, click on setting, then over here get into services, control, then over here on control select allow remote control via HTTP, then select the port, type in a username. Let's say that is OSMC, then a password for that, choose whatever you want, I'll go with some default password, then enable this, enable this thing. I'm using Android over here. Let's get into Play Store and search for OSMC remote, and it'll get something like Yetse. So click on it, click on install, accept. So let's connect to the same Wi-Fi network over here. That is my OSMC is connected to. Then hit on open. And it will let you into a screen that will get started. Then click on got it, and it try to detect the host automatically. So if it is not automatically detected, you can add by yourself. So click on next and type in IP address of your OSMC. Let's type in the IP, the server port as we configured, that is 8080. Type in the username you set earlier as well as the password. Okay, click on add host. It will try to ping your OSMC Media Center. Now click on add host. So click on OK and it will sync all the files from your OSMC Media Center. Like over here you can see, as I have already added movies onto it and I have not added any music or so, it is only showing up the movies that I have already added onto the Media Center. So now you can see that it is showing up different movies and all, and you can directly play the required movie or music from your phone. Hit on play. And we'll have, and you can see all the libraries and all available on your Media Center. As well as you can navigate on your Media Center by using the remote interface. So if you want, you can navigate around your Media Center by using this. So that's all with this app. And if you are interested in any other app, there are plenty of apps, those are available for controlling the OSMC Media Center. So you can go with any app that you are comfortable with. So that's all with this, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you have liked this video. If so, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you have not subscribed yet, you can definitely subscribe to my channel for latest updates and videos like this. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.